and welcome to episode 30 of Sustainability Simplified, your bi-monthly dose of how to seamlessly build an action-oriented, sustainable and profitable business. We're also the official podcast for the Sustainability Council Network, an international network of sustainability enthusiasts, professionals and entrepreneurs registered on sustainabilitycouncil.in. I'm your host, Zitin, and today we'll be getting into conversation with Sonika, who leads Happy Souls. And what a, well, happy name. We'll find out more about what exciting work they do in just a minute. Welcome, Sonika. It's wonderful to have you on the show. How are you doing today?
Hi, Zitin. Thank you so much for having me on this beautiful podcast, Sustainability Simplified. By the way, I love the name as well. How beautiful it is, right? Everything is just simple, you know? And that's what we all love. We want a simple life and simplicity in everything. Yeah, I'm glad to be here, doing well. Happy to be a part of this conversation. And let's just get started.
Sure. That's amazing. I'm well too. So let's dive in. Could you begin by sharing a little bit about Happy Souls and how did the idea really come about?
It's a short story, Zitin. Happy Souls, I'll tell you about the name later, but I'll just tell you what do we do as a company. Happy Souls as a company, we support grassroots level NGOs in India. So when I say grassroots level NGOs, these are very small scale NGOs. It can be orphanages, schools, shelter homes, or old age homes, right? The smaller scale ones, you know, where the beneficiaries are directly staying. The origin of this idea was when I moved cities within India. I moved to a new city I was just trying to look out for NGOs nearby my place where I could actually donate my stuff, you know, considering the generation that we belong to, we are shopaholics, right? So we keep on shopping and there are times when we end up not even wearing it and our wardrobe, it just gets, you know, cluttered and that there is just no space. And yeah. The best thing that you can do is, I mean, as an Indian family, what we do is we end up giving it to our maids. But there are times when the maids also don't need it. They don't wear Western stuff, right? And the sizes does not fit in. And that's when you look out for ways, you know, how can you actually put those things in good use, right? And that's when I was looking out for NGOs nearby my place, right? And unfortunately, I just could not find anything which is close to my place, right? I googled it, I went on Google Maps, but somehow I just could not find me. At times the NGOs does not exist, at times they do not take old clothing, and at times the address is there but the NGO does not exist altogether, the phone number is not reaching.
Yeah.
There were a lot of challenges, right? And that's when, you know, I thought that how easy or simple it could be, you know, if there could have been a Zomato for NGOs, you know, so just a small scale NGO, not the registered offices of NGOs, but actually where beneficiaries are staying, wherein you can go, spend some time, do something, check out what they need and just support them, right? So, that's how it was born. And that's when I decided, okay, it's not there. Let me just, do something in this space. And I myself visited more than 60 NGOs myself, just to understand the kind of challenges that they have been facing and what kind of support do they need. And that's when I realized that, you know, that the smaller NGOs, they do not crave for cash donation. You know, there are so many websites, crowdfunding websites that you see online, which are doing a tremendous job in terms of helping NGOs. But these small NGOs, they are happy to get any kind of support. They are happy that even if they are like that, if you have anything which is in usable condition, in good condition for sure, it can be clothing, toys, stationery, books, anything, you know, furniture, anything that you have, just we are happy to get any kind of support because these children, it's a luxury for them, right? And that's when I thought that, you know, that why not, how come, and there are, trust me, there are so many people. I mean, the NGOs, they told me that we are so blessed that there are so many good people out there who want to support and they help us, you know, and they come and drop it at our NGO. But at times, people are busy, you know, metro cities,
yeah.
It's a busy lifestyle. And then they ask the NGOs to come and pick up the stuff, you know, and unfortunately, these small scale NGOs, they don't have enough of resources or maybe, you know, the logistics to take care of all of that stuff, right? And there is a gap, right? So there is a lot of demand and supply, but then there is nothing in between, someone that can actually join these two together. And yeah, there we go, bang on. We launched Happy Souls. It started with as a service to basically support grassroots level NGOs. And considering that people want to donate, we structured this entire market, right? We tried to digitalize this entire old goods donation market. And right. What we do is we just pick up the donations from your doorstep. Since we've already partnered, I mean, till now we have more than 400 NGOs working with us. I mean, we've partnered with us. So we know, we pick up the donation from your house and we send it out to our NGO partner, which is in need of the same, right? So that's what we do. As a company, we are trying to structure this entire market, change the traditional methods wherein people will just collect everything at one point and keep on collating it and keeping it in boxes. And then probably once in 6 months, you go and then give it to the NGOs. By the time it reaches the NGOs, there are times when the donation has got, it has got that dirt, or maybe it has started smelling. So by the time it reaches the NGO, probably those goods are spoiled or maybe not in a good condition. So what we do is we just take it up from your doorstep and directly send it out to the NGO so that the donations gets instantly used, right? And trust me, with so many people coming on our website and donating, it's so much of happiness that it gives us. The children, they look out for what have we got today, they'll look out for it, because and that for them it's something, gift that somebody has sent, right? So that's what we do. We take anything which is in usable condition, from clothing, toys, utensils, furniture, appliances, sports items, bicycles, anything that you have, which you think that is just taking up space in your home. Trust me, I mean, that's something that we send it out to the NGOs, where it adds a lot of meaning in the lives of people that we support.
Wonderful. That was absolutely fantastic. You did speak about, challenges that you face, and really what would be the opportunities in the space, and you fleetingly spoke about it. I want you to get into a little bit more depth about it and talk to our viewers about, what have been the challenges, what have been the opportunities you've been able to capitalize on since you started this journey.
Yeah. Yeah, I think every startup, it has its own journey, right? And there is no excitement till the time you have those challenges, because that's how you learn and that's how you actually progress. Your idea actually shapes into a company, and you have those customers. And I think the most people that I have learned from is our customers itself, right? I mean, before I started this idea, these donation pickups, right? When we started it long back, initially when I was doing a pilot on this entire idea, I was just going and picking up the donations myself, right? So I will maybe go on in an auto, or at times just take my car and go and do the pickups, talk to the customers that, how did they find the platform and how we can make it better, just to understand the pricing point. Because one challenge that I faced here is that people think that when we are donating something, then we don't need to pay for anything, for that. And that is one challenge that initially we faced, that even today, right, the certain set of people will be like that, we are donating, why do we have to pay for the pickups? Because, and then we tell them that, the NGOs that we work with, these are very small scale NGOs, and, we do not charge anything. Our platform is absolutely free for the NGOs, right? And we just support them with in-kind donations. So that is one thing, I mean, that we initially faced, but then we learned from the customers. There are certain set of customers who told us that this is fantastic, this is something that we've been looking for. Because when we do it ourselves, of course, we invest our time, we invest our own operations, right? Going and delivering it to the engine. Somebody doing it so transparently for us is something which is amazing, right? So we learned from it, we evolved from that. We evolved on our business model, as in what kind of pickups do we need. So we do have like a bike pickup, an auto pickup, a four-wheeler pickup, and even bulk pickups. because I do have like lovely customers who are shifting countries and they just want to donate everything, right? So and they're very glad to donate all of this stuff and pay for the logistics because our platform is absolutely transparent, right? So once it is delivered to the NGOs, we also keep our customers updated as in where the donations have went and how it has impacted the lives of the children and the beneficiaries who are staying there. Right. And yeah, apart from that, we do have like operational challenges coming up. So initially I did the pickups myself. Then, of course, as we scale, we were looking out for a logistics partner. And I'm lucky that, you know, that in fact, we are lucky that in India, how the startup culture is evolving. And there are so many logistics company which has come up that we've partnered with to help us with the logistics for the pickups and drops. Overall, yes, I mean, I think there are a lot of opportunities that keep on coming and with opportunities, of course, there are challenges that keeps coming as well. And we keep on learning from it and we keep on evolving with it. And yeah, we are really looking forward to more and more such opportunities.
Fantastic. Fantastic. Thank you. Thank you so much. Thanks so much for sharing that. It's wonderful to know all the great work that you do. And just on another note, now we know that, you know, Diwali is around the corner and we're always on the lookout to kind of give our clothes away, give, you know, donations and so on and so forth. Could you please tell us more about how each one of us can get involved into this deeper journey of contribution, you know, helping the mission of Happy Souls?
Right. Yeah, that's a lovely thought, Zitin. And, you know, most of us in India, you know, Diwali, when it comes, we all just come together and just start cleaning our houses. And that's when we actually realize, oh, my God, there's so much, you know, in the house that we don't use anymore. Right. And we, of course, want to give it for good. Right. We want to donate that stuff. So bang on, yes, the Diwali is coming. I would encourage each and everyone, just come on to Happy Souls website and just click on donate all goods and then you will see list of items that we actually accept. You can donate from clothing, from men, women and children to toys or anything that you have at your corner, any furniture piece that you're not using. You can just schedule the pickup. You can come on our website, add a tentative quantity of goods that you're donating, right? Because it helps us as a company and for you as a donor, as a customer, to know that how much have you donated ultimately, you know, how much was lying at your home. And that number has finally reached an NGO and you get to know how many children, how many lives have actually got impacted with it. So you can come to the website, you can schedule the pickup basis your convenience, whichever date is convenient for you. We do provide next day pickups. Depending upon the volume of donation, we have different sorts of pickups, as I had mentioned. And bang on, I mean, I think including the children, the beneficiaries at the NGOs, they really look forward to this time because they know that, you know, people have been decluttering and they are looking forward to, and we're really looking forward to some like good donations. Last Diwali, we had like lovely customers who donated, you know, their wedding saris and all, and we gave it to one of the NGOs and there was these girls, you know, these are teenage girls and they have like farewell in their school or college and they were so excited to, you know, wear those saris and we got the pictures. It's lovely, right? I mean, there is nothing, that's what the company is all about, you know, Happy Soul. We do have our hearts and our mind that keeps on struggling between what we want, but our soul is someone that needs, you know, When you give it to others, right, the kind of happiness it gives to your inner self, that's amazing. So, yeah, I think I encourage everyone during this festive season, whether it is Dussehra, Diwali, Christmas, just let's just declutter for good this Diwali. Come to Happy Soul, support us and support our NGOs that we work with. And let's create love and light for all.
Wonderful. What a thought. What a thought. On that note, I think it would be nice if you can share the website as well. Of course, I'll add it, you know, in the description.
Yes.
But if you can share, you can share the website as well. That would be great.
Oh, yes. It's HAPPIEESOULS. So it's happy. It's not HAPPY. Just make sure that you type in HAPPIEESOULS.com and you can just visit our website and you'll get everything.
Wonderful, wonderful. We also have Joy of Giving Week that's going on. And that's also another opportunity to kind of declutter, donate, and give for good, right? That was fantastic. I want to conclude now with any advice that you might like to give to our viewers or listeners, especially those who are interested in this space.
I'd definitely like to mention, along with individuals, right? I would like to encourage the corporates, right, to participate in this drive, because they have been doing donate old goods kind of campaigns in their office campus, and in the societies also people do it, right? But I would encourage them to come on to, you know, partner with us, because we do have a corporate sustainable care program, and we got a very good response. We are working with one of the large corporates in India, and it's a beautiful short story that I'd like to share here. This is one of our customers, right, who had come, and she had scheduled a pickup. She was shifting cities, and she loved the idea, you know, and she was so happy that she actually pitched in our idea to her company, right, that this is something that we are doing, and why don't we partner with them? And it was so beautiful, because we do have a corporate sustainable care program wherein we digitalize the employee donation drives, right? So whatever you were doing traditionally,
yeah,
now your employees can donate from home, considering the pandemic and lots of employees working from home.
Wonderful.
And many of the companies are following a hybrid model, and some of the companies are still in the work from home model.
Yeah.
And just to involve your employees, right, in this act of giving, they can partner with us, come talk to us. And in fact, we basically, you know, make this entire activity measurable, right? Still now, when you were doing this traditional old goods donation market, you were not able to measure it. But now there is a means, since everything happens digitally, you will know how many items got donated, how many NGOs it has reached out to, how many lives have got impacted, right? And what all got donated, how many carbon emissions got reduced with this entire activity, because you increase the shelf life of goods and it goes for good. So that's something that we've been doing, and that donor, that customer of ours, she pitched the idea and it went so successfully. It was so well accepted there that we were getting requests from the same company. We were getting like global requests, you know, from Netherlands, from Germany, you know, from US. Do you have this concept in India? We'd like to run it here. So you know, that's really amazing, and we would like to, you know, reach out to more and more corporates to know about this program and partner with them, so that we can digitalize this, measure this, and organize this entire these donation drives in a more structured way.
Absolutely fantastic. Thank you so much, Sonika, for that. It was wonderful to have, you know, the conversation with you. And that brings us to the end of the conversation. I'm certain that this conversation would be motivating a lot of others to really start and continue their journey of building, you know, purposeful businesses like yours. So thank you once again. Thanks a lot. Take care. Yeah.
Thank you. Thank you so much, Zutan. It's a lovely opportunity, and I am so glad to be a part of this. Love the initiative that you have taken up. I think it's going to help millions, you know, to reach out to as many people as your platform can reach out to. And I really admire this and wish you all the luck. And yes, we are hoping to reach out to as many corporates and individuals. Just go to happysouls.com.
Wonderful. Thanks so much. Thanks so much, Sonika. Thank you again. Take care. Yeah.
Thank you. You too. Thanks, Uttan. Thank you so much.
Bye. Bye-bye. Thank you so much for listening. And if you like this podcast, feel free to share it in your network. My one takeaway from this episode was, it's Diwali time. It's Joy of Giving a week. And there are lots of festivals coming up. Go out there, declutter, and declutter for good. I would love to hear your key takeaway from today too. Do share it with me on my socials. I'm on @ZitinMunshi. That's @ZitinMunshi. See you next time.